everything old is new again and cooler than it ever was. Restyling and repurposing outdated pieces around the house is the latest DIY craze.
Yes, it is. Artist Stephanie Jones is here to show us at least one way to turn what you might think is trash into a brand new treasure for your home. Stephanie, can we all do this? Can we all make this happen?
Absolutely, absolutely. All we need to do is put the right brush in your hand and you're all set.
It's just that easy.
It is, I promise.
So you've got a cheap, hey, I shouldn't use that word, but it's
inexpensive. We like that verbiage.
Rescue.
You could get this at a garage sale because it's just a print.
Yes, it's just a print.
Going to do what?
Mm-hmm. What we're going to do is make it into a little chalkboard, which kind of gives it a new life and a new purpose. And I think a lot of families like to have those in their kitchen or at their little landing area when people come in.
That makes a lot of sense.
Reminder to pick up your shoes.
Exactly. Yeah, pick up the bread and the milk and the shoes.
So what do you do?
So what we're going to do is just, we're going to take, we have two paints that we love. Annie Sloan's chalk paint, which will adhere to almost anything with very, very little prep. All I did was Windex this glass off, and we're just going to put the paint right on the glass.
Okay, and it's actually, Stephanie, called chalk paint?
It is called chalk paint, which is, there's a little bit of a misconception about what it really is. Annie named it that because it feels chalky and matte when it's dry. It's not that there's an especially lot of chalk in it. In fact, most paints have some calcium carbonate in them as a binder, so it's a little bit, it's caused a little bit of confusion because I think some people think that we're just adding chalk to latex paint, but this is a totally unique kind of paint.
And it acts like a chalkboard after it's dry, right?
Yes, it will if you want it to, or you can seal it with wax and it gives a beautiful, kind of an authentic old world finish with wax. So it really isn't intended strictly as a chalkboard, although we do use it for that sometimes, but you can see it's going right onto the glass really nicely. So it usually takes a couple of coats of paint to cover something slick.
Okay.
But as you see, there's no odor, it dries quickly, it's water-based, so it's soap and water cleanup, and it's really terrific.
Let me ask you this, your technique, you're going this way, that way, you're going to, is that a particular technique that does something, or is that
just... It's really nice with the paints that we love, with chalk paint and with milk paint that I'll show y'all in a minute. You can be very loose with your paint strokes.
So you don't have to
this
be...
This is my kind of painting,
exactly.
Man.
You're
this
not having to go straight with the grain and be fussed with it. If the doorbell rings or the dog barks, you can put it down and come back to it later. You don't have to, you know, finish it all in one fell swoop the way
so
you do with other...
And so you won't see those streaks.
Most of it is going to kind of lay down as the paint dries. And if it doesn't, it's just going to give you that beautiful handcrafted look. So it's really easy to work with. So once that dries, you'll be able to take chalk and just say, you know, we love Live at 9 or something. And what's your little thing? There you go.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, look at that.
Wow, look at
you know as well, Stephanie, you really do.
Okay, so if I want it to match my little entryway, my mud room, my kitchen, whatever, that then you paint the frame accordingly?
Exactly. Then you can just take, and what I've done is I've mixed up some milk paint, which is another earth-friendly, water-based paint that we love.
So milk paint.
Mm-hmm. Oh. It comes as a powder form, and you just mix it with a little water when you're ready to use it, and then you can use that, and again, great adherence, no odor, dries quickly. Ooh, and I just made a
But that's okay because you can go back over it, right?
I can go back over that, and so we're just going to use that to cover the frame. And then as soon as that's dry, you can take a damp sponge. If you wanted to do a little distressing like we did over here, you can just take a damp sponge and kind of wipe away a little bit of the paint to reveal some of that old silver and let that come through. And it adds a little age and, you know, a little depth to the frame.
Stephanie, got about a minute left here. Okay. Got something else you want to show us over here as well?
Oh, these are just some finished samples of some of the furniture finishes that we do with the milk paint and chalk paint, and by adding the wax, again, you can give a little more depth to the finish. We have a little antiquing wax, and we like to kind of stipple that on with a brush, kind of get it in there, give the piece a little bit of age if you'd like
to. That is so pretty.
And again, that's just an option, you know, an optional kind of final step. It'll protect the finish and give it a little patina as well.
But you can't really mess it up is the point.
Exactly. These products are so forgiving. It's wonderful.
And so very special event Saturday in Germantown, and there's going to be some mini workshops, and so we're going to get the weather all cleared up for this because you have some very special people coming in.
Yes, we have gorgeous weather coming.
Awesome.
So yes, a week from Saturday.
Much.
Thank you.
Right,
thank
Stephanie,
you so
we like
much.
This a lot.
Well, good.
So glad
thank
to have you.
I'm so happy to be here. Thank you.